Saturday.
Wow, this is the first time I actually seen leather shorts in a store. Yeah. Because I own like leather sweatpants, so to actually see the shorts here is just like,
wow. We have leather sweatpants, we have leather pants, we have suede sweatpants, and these are new, the suede Escobars.
Wow.
In charcoal.
Yeah.
They fit like the ones that you have on.
Wow.
Look at this view right here. Look at this. Such a vibe right now. Dang. Wow, that is crisp.
Okay, before we start the video, let me just go ahead and address it, all right? I broke out right here. I don't know what it is. I don't know what happened. I don't know if it's like shaving bumps or like what. It broke out, so I know you guys are gonna see it, and I just wanna go ahead and address it right now, because I always know there's gonna be an a-hole in the comment section that wants to be like, oh, you broke out, what's that right there? So boom, I already addressed it, okay? I'm sorry, I'm not one of those YouTubers that have like a whole hair and makeup set before I grab a camera, before I can start filming. And if that was the case, I would just grab one of these robes and put like a cigar in my mouth right before I'm filming and like front and act a certain way. But look, I'm just being 100% real, I'm human. But with that said, I just wanna say right now, as you see by the title, I'm back in the beautiful city of Miami. And I thought to myself, you know what? I wanna go ahead and make a quick vlog simply because, interesting enough, everyone's been hitting me up through a few, you know, emails. I think a couple of you guys actually sent me a link to John Elliott clothing, John Elliott stuff. And then even my other friend was like, oh, you know, there's John Elliott. You heard of John Elliott, try John Elliott clothing. And what's interesting is that I heard of John Elliott before. I think I heard of him. I think I read about him like one time in like GQ. And I know he's like heavy with joggers and everything. And crazy enough, he actually grew up in San Francisco, if I'm not mistaken. And he doesn't really have a storefront out there in his like his hometown, but he has three storefronts, which I hear, which is LA, Hollywood, Los Angeles, New York, and Miami. And guess where I'm at? I'm out here in Miami. So I thought to myself, you know what? Let's go ahead and try to make a vlog visiting the John Elliott store. Let's see if I can just go in there. I don't know what district that's in. I don't know if that's the design district, if that's downtown, but we're gonna go ahead and find out. And we'll see what the store actually looks like. I know he carries, I think he carries leather sweatpants. So it would be awesome to just be able to see a pair of leather sweatpants in person. I've never seen them in person in a store. So we'll go ahead and check that out. But for now, guys, look at this view right now, man. This view right here is breathtaking right now. Dang, man. Like, here, let's see if we could just focus that in. Look at that. Ooh, dang, man. I feel like fabulous, man. And that music video, I'm So Into You, off his album Street Dreams. Or I feel like Charlie Sheen in that show 2 and a Half Men when they all lived on the beach house. Ooh, dang, man. I could just sit here and look at this view all day right now, man. I'm just sitting here just counting, man, like all my blessings, everything I'm just so grateful for. But let's go ahead without further ado and let's check it out at the John Elliott store right now. Currently, if you guys are curious where I'm at, I'm actually staying right now Mid Beach. So where I'm at right now, Mid Beach is like you're not like super right in action where South Beach is, where it's all like crazy. Obviously, South Beach is where all the, you know, hot women are and everything, and like, you know, all the buff guys and everything out in that area. And then you come right up here to like Mid Beach and you're a little bit like right in the middle of the beach. It's a little bit slightly more quieter, but then you're not too far from the action. I could just get back down to the action real easily. And then obviously then there's North Beach, which then the hotels get even like really nicer, but then you're just kind of like far away from like all the action. But if you just really want to chill and like zone out, it's all good. So very nice. Also real quick, just looking at this view right now, I got inspired in so many ways just to give everybody a piece of advice right now. To all you guys out there that want to travel, you guys want to go visit different cities, visit different islands all around the world, don't wait on anybody else, right? Like everybody out there, stop waiting on other people. Stop feeling like, oh, I got to go wait till my other friend has the same schedule as me and then we're going to go book the trip together and we're going to go do it. Or I got to wait till my girlfriend comes with me and she has to take off work and da 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 and do this. Guys, if you're waiting on other people to travel, you'll never travel. You'll never see the entire world. And even if you do finally go somewhere with somebody else, just the amount of, you know, whole time and energy it takes to schedule it and work their schedule out and come with you, I mean, you'll never be able to see the world in a way that you could with just the amount of time and just be able to go visit all these different spots, right? And the best part about it is like when I see this view right here,
it feels good to know if I want, I can go venture out on that beach without having to like go check with somebody like, oh, do you want to go do that? If I want, I can go head into the city right now and go shopping if I want to do that, right? If I want, I can head down to South Beach and go get, you know, lunch right now, right? Like, there's nothing, there's nobody that's like, oh, I got to go check with them. There's nobody that's trying to catch up with me or like, oh, where are they at? Let me, what do they want to do, right? Like, I know some of you guys out there too, you might be an entrepreneur, you might work remotely, right? You might have no kids, you might have no mortgage. And I feel like, look, if you made it that far, if you made it that far in life where you don't have like those, you know, huge responsibilities, you dodged all those bullets and you're not traveling, what are you doing, right? Like, it feels like you're almost like gypping yourself, right? And you got to look at it like, if you're waiting on other people, right? Other people, they got their schedules, they got this, right? They may not be in the same position as you, right? So why wait around for other people, right? I think Wiz Khalifa had a verse. He says, more money in the bank, less time spent waiting on someone else. That's exactly it right there, guys, right? Like, if you want to go, go ahead, go take a trip, right? And just go travel like solo, right? Everybody's acting like, oh, I can't go solo. I have to go with somebody, right? I got to go wait on them. And I've even heard situations where people are like, oh, okay, John booked the trip. Now, Timothy booked the trip. Okay, we're all getting ready to go. Then all of a sudden, one person pulls out like, oh, I can't go anymore. I have to actually go do this. Then all of a sudden, because that one person pulled out, everybody pulled out. Now you don't go. Like, how is that even a way to live? How are you even going to live your life just waiting on other people, right? So, guys, don't wait on other people to travel. Get out there, travel, even if it means by yourself. If you have people to come with you, cool, but don't wait around other people. So I'm just simply out here taking my little, you know, morning walk, just clearing my head. Like I said earlier, I just kind of wanted to walk the beach before I head to downtown. So, ooh, look at that beautiful coastline. Very, very refreshing. Gosh, man, it's just so nice. So the humidity is back. I'm feeling that humidity is warm again. So I was wrong earlier when I said that, I guess when I touched down, like later on the night, it was cooler, but now it's starting to warm up, but it's okay. It's beautiful. I love it. So I'm gonna just go clear my head. Then after that, I'm gonna head down to the downtown area.
That boy worldwide. Donna Valley, that boy worldwide.
This is distressed, huh? This yeah, like distressed. It's like that new style kind of coming in.
Yeah, but it's different though. If you see this one, it's more thin, mm-hmm. and it's different.
Mm-hmm. Just a huge fan of like the whole like John Elliott. Like I know he only has like three stores
right.
in LA, New York, and Miami.
Right.
I'm from the Bay Area. I'm from like San Francisco. So I never really got to see any of his stores.
Okay.
So I'd always like jump online. I would see kind of like John Elliott stuff. I'd see
and you have to try it on. You
at Nordstrom's and everything. So
I don't think we're at Nordstrom anymore. If you find something at Nordstrom, it's like really, really, really old.
Mm-hmm.
Because since he has the boutiques now, mm-hmm. everything is going to the boutiques.
Boutiques?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So a lot of his clothing is just really in the store here and then online.
And in LA. And in all of the stores, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But this is what you see at the store is what's happening right
wow.
now.
Wow. Leather pants.
Leather
wow, this is the first time I actually seen leather shorts in a store.
Yeah.
because I own like leather sweatpants, so to actually see the shorts here is just like,
wow. We have leather sweatpants, we have leather pants, we have suede sweatpants, so these are new, the suede Escobars.
Wow.
In charcoal.
Yeah.
They fit like the ones that you have on.
Wow. Yeah. Tailor made. Wow. Oh, wow. This feels like just quality.
It's suede, yeah. And they still have that stretch that sweatpants have.
That is beautiful. Wow, and then the sizes that you have are just all up here. I mean, or I guess you just have these.
No, we have all the sizes in the back.
Okay.
Because before the store, the way that the store was set up was like that capsule over here.
Mm-hmm.
It was everything, all the same brand, the same collection, mm-hmm. with the different colors. So you knew that this comes in the black, mm-hmm. and it comes in the blue or whatever. But now it's more by looks,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Wow.
By looks, for everything we have in different colors.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Everything we have in different.
And then this is all the men's section down here.
This is all the men's,
mm-hmm.
and once it's over these two.
Okay. And then this is just your main front. There's no other like side part where it's
No. The outfit is just our stock.
Okay.
Yeah, for now. We'll see in the future.
Wow. Okay. Oh.
Yeah, we are huge with jeans.
Yeah. Distressed jeans. Wow.
So I'm back from the design district right now. I know you guys see me in the store with the phone. I was trying to record a little bit with the salesperson was telling me. I was trying to be discreet. I wasn't trying to have a camera all over everybody's face. But must I say, first and foremost, my thoughts on that design district in general, wow. Like right now, I just got to say, like I've been to San Francisco, LA, Las Vegas, and now here at Miami. And I must say, right now, nothing really tops Miami. Right now, Miami is like first place when it just comes to like shopping and like just the whole districts and everything like that. Like, first off, it had every single like designer brand that you could think of. Like every single one that you just kind of like see online that you didn't even they had a storefront, it was there, right? Like I've seen Off-White. I mean, I even seen that brand Bathing Apes. I mean, I remember I heard of that brand. I didn't even know that brand was that big, right? And I didn't even know it was really an expensive brand, but obviously, if it was in that district, I mean, it must be like, you know, so expensive brand. I've heard other people mention it. So
everything about like that whole area, it was just like, wow, welcoming, and everyone was out shopping. It just, even on a Wednesday, it was like decently crowded, and like you seen people there. I mean, honestly, just being out here, man, I just fell in love with the entire culture. Like, it was really like no other, right? Like, you know, other spots where I come from, it feels like everybody is so, you know, always like moving fast and like rushing to like get to where they have to go and everything. But like out here, it was just like chill, laid back, and just like everyone was just smiling and like cool and just welcoming in the whole spot. So my thoughts on the whole John Elliott store, to like, to be specific, again, you could really sense like it was like that boutique type of vibe. Like they had like a handful of like selections there, and then like everything was like way like full price, right? Like nothing was on sale, right? The leather sweatpants, I think that I looked at, they were going for like $1,800, I mean, plus tax, I'll probably run up to like $2,000. Even underwear, just a pack of underwear was going for like $100. So that right there was definitely insane, but I mean, I get it, right? Like it's a boutique, you know, type of spot. The leather sweatpants that I seen, that was the first time I've actually seen leather sweatpants in person. And when I seen those right there, I mean, the quality in them, they looked really great. They felt great. The only thing I will say is that I kind of didn't really like the bottom. I like to have the little cuffs on the ankles versus having like some little string to tighten it at the bottom. So that's just my thing. But yeah, other than that, guys, I'm just, again, taking in the culture. It's just really crazy. I mean, just wow. Like just everywhere you go, like, I mean, just so many good looking, like just people, Spanish women and everything. I'm just culture shocked right now. So other than that, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like the video, subscribe down below to the channel. Here, let me give you one last view right here of the hotel room. Look at that. There you guys go. Beautiful. Don't wait on other people to travel, all right? Stop waiting on so-and-so to book a trip. Stop waiting on so-and-so to get off work. Just go ahead, book the trip. Even if that means you gotta go by yourself, just go ahead and do it.
Play and meditate, extra out the way. Hit my phone, don't get an answer. Off a lot of game, I don't rock it wave. I don't do it for the camera. Silver spoon.